feast today for dinner. Sorry, my vision is a bit fucked right now, so like that Schultz guy. Spooter. She's coming. It's a reference from a podcast me and Maddie listened to. Well, of course I'm not going to know that if you and Matt listen to it. Is this... This isn't from your mum's house. No, that's Gear Spider. Gear Spider listens to your mum's house. Anyway, I've got to get cracking because I've got lots to do so we can be eating about 6:30, 7 p.m. We're making our voices. I've got my filling that I prepared earlier. Pork, plum and coriander, which we're going to be using. And I've got my bamboo steamers and some water and a dumpling press. So yeah, we're good. But yeah. Kip is in the office. He's working at the moment. When he's done, when he's finished working, he will come in and give me a hand in the kitchen. And what it is, Rhoda has ever so generously offered to work on the potato, Glittercunt, who has died in the ass again. Again. Is it working now? Again, again, you're doing more than what I've been able to do with it. This is the reason why. I should have freaking studied IT, not graphic design. I studied the wrong thing. I should have studied IT instead of graphic design. Tim, how are you doing today? John, how are you doing? Tina? All right, pork, oh, before we do, I've got to wet the edges, otherwise they're not going to seal. So a goiza is like a pan-fried Japanese dumpling. And also I've got lots of ginger in there, tamari, mirin, sake, a bit of plum sauce, coriander, spring onion. Wet all these cunts. Oh, Tim, you know what arrived today? The Korean barbecue burner. The plates will be arriving in either tomorrow or Friday, so... I am like so. I'm no longer worried that I don't know what we're gonna do for Korean barbecue night. So I'm like shit. When it arrived, it fucking arrived. All right. So what we're gonna do now is put in our goiza filling, like so. Only males in the family. You're shitting me. Oh, Tim, at my mum's, yeah, the rota has just swept through everyone. And I took a rat yesterday, negative. I took a rat today because I'm still feeling pretty sick. Negative. So I'm definitely putting it down to autoimmune being a absolute cunt, as my body normally does. Alright, so just going to get that in there. I'm gonna get about 25 goiza. I can't eat these. So I'm gonna make me probably some rice paper roll things with the goiza filling because I don't wanna get sick. You want health issues, bruh? I've got a fucking 35 centimeter blood clot in my leg. You want health, do you want health issues, bruh, Schultz? I've got 3 autoimmune diseases that cause me shit on a daily basis. I would happily take a blood clot in the leg. All right, let's seal these bastards up. You wanna fight me, bruh? How about we do it like with the Eshays fight at Warrington Station, Schultz? Yeah, that's... Well, I've been in bed all day today. I've been in bed all day today. Alright. So I'm just gonna put them on here. Press them, seal them. And we've got our little bamboo steamers. Mine can kill me at any time. Mine can kill me anytime too. I'm just waiting for thyroid cancer to, you know, to do its thing in my thyroid. All right, so what we do, we've got our one dumpling, so push it down like so. So they'll be able to stand up in the steamer. So then we're just gonna fill up our steamer with lots of goizas. And yeah. Alright, I'm just trying to think. This will take me about probably 35 minutes. Then I'll whip up the sauces. They won't take too long. then I will do the katsu, which shouldn't take me too long either.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Fuck yeah. Fill up the steamer. Is that euphemism for cunt? Shots. Steamed hams. All right, when I did the Simpsons episode, I was thinking about making steamed hams, but then I realized they're just fucking hamburgers, you know?
Wow, what's penis so big. So big, oh. Penis.
Kip, can you get ScoMo down? I've got raw pork on my fingers. I really don't want to have to get ScoMo down right now. Thanks, babe. Menu boards in the right hand corner. Pork katsu, goiza, and sushi. Yep. Thanks, Tina. But yeah, Tim, I can't believe it. The burner arrived, and it's a fucking powerful burner too. Because Kip had some butane canisters in the garage, and we put it in there. It has a bloody good flame, so we're gonna have good Korean barbecue. Good Korean barbecue. All right. Put that one in there. I think we'll hopefully be able to fit maybe another four more in that soon. I've got three steamer baskets, so I think I'll be able to fit all of them, no problems. Get them there. So what's the news, anyone? Schultz, you done anything interesting lately? Alright, get that bastard in there like so.
Hey! Fuck you!
This is the problem I have with these damn dumpling wrappers. They're not the most easiest things to work with. That in there like so. I'll probably have to fit two more in there, one and two, hopefully. Hopefully, hopefully, hopefully. Like so. Oh, nice. Man, you know how expensive of having a free feed for my parents, Tim? I've not been to dinner at my mum's house, my mum and dad's place, I think since... Dear God, I'm talking probably like 9 months ago, maybe longer. Like, I never go down there for free food anymore. And on Wednesday, I'm going there to cook dinner for my dad's birthday. So yeah, another visit where I don't get free food. I remember the good old days when I didn't stream, Tim. I used to go to mum's at least once a month for a meal. All right, so we have one steamer basket full of our goiza, and then I will start doing the rest. So this is one down. We've got three more of these bastards to fill. So we'll get another one in there like so. Like that. This one here has been a bit of a dick. Tina, do you make a lot of like dumplings and stuff? Because I know you do a lot of Thai food. Is there such a thing as Thai dumplings? Is he getting one, Tim? Is he getting a PS5 for his birthday? That's pretty awesome. My old man wants an arcade machine because he saw my arcade machine and he wants one. I'm like, oh, Dad, I really can't afford that. I really can't afford to buy my old man an arcade machine because they're pretty fucking expensive. And besides Cripple Claws, I would give it to him, but I don't want to because Cripple Claws is coming on the weekend to play arcade games for his birthday. And I'm going to make cake and some food and all that shit. Russian dumplings, pelmeni. Are they like, what are the pierogies? Are they like pierogies? Or are they a little bit different? Dostari, how are you doing? Because pierogies are the shit. I fucking love pierogies. Those things are freaking amazing. Alright, clean this up. Start the process again. Dostari, now that you quit those other two jobs, mate, do you have a little bit more free time? Like, do you have more, you know, downtime, me time, you know, coffee time, gym time? Topless boobs? Why, do you want me to rate your boobs? Do you want me to rate your boobs? Look, I ain't sending anyone back in return. You got to pay for that shit, all right? Yeah, look, I'll rate them. I'll rate them. It's not like I've never seen boobs. I have a cert. Alright, that's another 10, and I've got another, like, I think 8 there, so let's get going by filling. Oh, sorry, before we fill them, we've got to wet them. Oh, Tim, premium, I haven't had any time to create content, so forget about April. May is going to be where I'm going to have to restart again, so premium, don't worry about it. Because I've been so tired and so stressed and so overworked, it's this month has taken its toll on me. So yeah, so this month, don't worry about it. This has been it's been a hell of a month. Because we've got a lot on, like a lot on this month. Because next fortnight, next weekend, not this weekend, is our great big subathon weekend, where it's gonna be basically 3 days of stuff. Send 2, please. I'll be critical but fair. Not like pierogies, they're small. Oh, so they're more like a tortellini. Okay. The Korean dumplings that are called mandu, they look a lot like a tortellini too. But they look like a big tortellini. I was going to make mandu for Korean barbecue, but then I realised we're going to have so much food as it is. You know, stuff making mandu dumplings on Korean barbecue, because the menu, oh my god, we're gonna have pork belly, we're gonna have kangaroo, we're gonna have those Vietnamese meatballs, we're gonna have fillet steak that's marinated in bulgogi sauce. We're also gonna have tofu for the for Mrs. Muffs, who's a vegetarian, a whole selection of veggies, some other sizzle steak as well, pork marinated pork. There's going to be tons of food for Korean barbecue, so I don't think I need to make mandu, because, yeah, I think we're going to have plenty as it is. John Bert, no one's seen my Solid C cup! Seeing Bert with a headache was like massive euphoria moment, so like, well, I'm having a fair share of them. I think my internet's... It's all good. You know, my internet's pretty shit too. If you need to reset or, you know, kill it for the night, Dostari, all good. All right, so... dumpling filling. Now it's gonna press these bastards up like so. Don't overstuff them because they're really, really hard to fucking seal. These things are cunts. Ugh. Oh, I just got it because you can't sleep. Well, I hope you're lying down like in bed or something watching. Alright, seal the dumpling. I'm jealous, I love these things, but I promised myself I was not gonna spend an hour and a half dicking around with gluten-free dumpling skins, because I'm like, yeah, nah. I've got better things to do. I'd rather have like extra sushi for me. You know what I noticed? Ibuprofen doesn't do shit for headaches for me. Do what Kip does, mix it with paracetamol. Take ibuprofen and paracetamol. Alright, get that little fucker in there like so. Oh, tramadol, isn't that, don't you see people when you, I want, is tramadol the green whistle, Schultz? Because I once was given the green whistle for severe pain, and oh my God, I was seeing people who weren't there. It was fucking insane. Hey Ryan, how you doing? Oh, paracetamol. Paracetamol. It's Panadol. Oh wait, you don't have one Panadol year, in the baby. States, do you? Jacko, thank you for the 1 year of subbing. Cheers. How the fuck are you doing? I'm making some goiser at the moment. Just a reminder, everyone, we have got stream slots open. If anyone wants to be a sponsor, we've got a few stream slots open, especially the Korean barbecue stream and our pre-Anzac Day Bogan barbecue stream. If 10 AUD or higher is going to get you sponsorship. Yes, Tina, tomorrow night is Nuggy and C Day. So tomorrow night, Kip will be making the nugs. I'm not making the nugs. It's all up to Kip. It's all up to Kippo. Doing all right, Jacko? Nice, nice, nice. Ryan, what time is it for you? And yeah, Tina, you are the Nuggy and C Day sponsor. Kip's going to make fried chicken nuggies with a creamy barbecue sauce to dip it in. So that's what he's gonna make, so yeah. I'm ready for gluten-free whatever with a feck of salt. Omnitron, these are not gluten-free, believe it or not. I am not gonna spend my time dicking around making gluten-free dumpling wrappers because it's a prick. I absolutely hate making gluten-free dumpling wrappers. So I'm not having any of these. Tram is hectic, great way to binge a series and not remember a thing. Are you on the tram at the moment, John? Wait, Schultz, did I miss something? Who wasn't talking? Cornmeal and water for dumpling skins? Are you insane, Dulastari? You cannot roll that shit out thin enough. But no, what it is, I use a mixture of rice flour, tapioca flour, corn flour, potato starch. Oh, that's right. Their cornmeal's empanada, isn't it? Empanadas are thicker. You need them thin for like goises and dumplings and shit. Rhoda, if you just want to call it quits, you definitely can, mate, because this thing has been the bane of my existence for the last 2 months. I feel so bad. Rhoda travelled all the way up from Melbourne, and right now he's working on the potato computer.
I'm not loose.
I have a tortilla press too, Dulastari. I just haven't had time to use it. That's all it is. I've just been like really, like right now my neck, I feel like someone has cracked my neck in the wrong places everywhere. And what I do when I make my gluten-free dumplings, I use my my sheet roller thing for pasta. All right, so we've got another, well, actually we'll be able to fit one more in there if we try. Oh yeah, we got it in there. So we've got another tray, another steamer basket of dumplings. We've got one more that we're gonna fill, and these will be ready to cook, then we'll be pan frying them when we're about to serve dinner. So the plan is the pork katsu is gonna be served with a little bit of shredded wombok cabbage, crispy, juicy pork cutlet that's been deep fried, miso sauce, kewpie mayonnaise, pickled ginger, spring onion, and that's pretty much going to be the pork miso katsu. And everyone knows those vegetable cakey ajinigiris that I make on stream. I make them a lot. Yes, I saw you making the stock for all your friends who had COVID. Again? I'm too lazy to make soup. I just buy stuff, you know, in a pouch or something. I'll make soup on stream, but if I'm not on stream, I'm probably not gonna spend time making it. It's just that lately the fatigue is really, really kicking me in the guts. Hey, Kamira! Yes, I'm making goiza. Only question is, what are you eating? I actually can't eat these because these are not gluten-free. These are for our guests and for Kippo. But I'll be chowing down on pork goza and vegetable cake aljinagiri as well. And Chimera, you know you have to get down here to actually steal them. You can't steal them through the wonders of the internet. Oh, then being sick, we make it. Oh, okay. I couldn't imagine an all-day process. The flavors in that soup would be insane. It's like, you know, when you make like a ramen broth or a pho broth that you spend all day making and just brings out everything in it. All right, so let's put in some more. Oh, wait, no, wet them first. And then we're good. The massive blue elephant. No, it's a penis. It's ScoMo. Just remember, everyone, vote this cunt out of office. We're going to the polls next month. My friend's pun, who's picky, said it was amazing. Don't you feel good when you get someone who's a really picky eater and they say the food's really good? It's wow, pretty rare when Kip's son goes, oh so my god, I love that penis. Food. Because he rarely says that because he's a picky little shit. That's why I mainly feed him chicken nuggets and sausages. Oh, J-Dogs, how you doing? Yes! Penis. This is ScoMo, our kitchen mascot. And he is uncircumcised because he's got foreskin right there. J-Dogs, how you doing? If you're offended by giant blue penises and swearing, you might want to go find another channel. If you're not offended by them, by all means, stay. We'll happily welcome you in. Just that some people do get offended by the big dick. I love penis, wait, what? Hey, there's nothing wrong with that. I love cock. All right, there's Emmy ready to fold out. Get offended, pretty much Omnitron. What it is, you can get offended elsewhere, pretty much. Look, I'm sorry, but this is too big for, yeah, this is massive. Like, absolutely, like, massive. I wouldn't want that in real life. Hell no. All right, let's do the rest of these goises, and I'll put them in the fridge, ready to be steamed and pan-fried. Hey Malika, how you doing? Welcome in. But yeah, we are making a Japanese feast here tonight for our guests from Victoria. Oh, Tim, I couldn't fit a soup maker in my kitchen. You know how many appliances I have, mate. I can't fit anything else in my kitchen. Thank you for the offer, but you know all the Korean barbecue stuff that I bought? We have to store it in the garage because I've got no room for it in the house. Semahor, how are you doing? It's smaller than an elephant penis. So I once saw one extending. Is it Freddy Got Fingered? There's an elephant dick in there. And he goes to the elephant as well. I know he does it to the horse. You know, I look, daddy, I'm a farmer. But doesn't he do that with an elephant as well? Oh, thanks, Dual Starry. But yeah, Tim, no one buys me any more appliances, please. I can't fit anything else in my kitchen. My garage is now storing all my pizza stuff and my Korean barbecue stuff because I physically can't fit anything else in here again. It's just too full. My mum has come to the point where she says, I've got too much stuff. I don't know if that's code for saying, Kat, give me some items. Thanks, J-Dogs. Cheers. Thank you for the follow, mate. For some reason, it's not coming up with Stream Elements. Stream Elements, fuck you. You just had to be fucking difficult today, didn't you? Apologies, what it is. Oh, there it goes. There is a massive, massive delay on that car. There. Fold this prick over. You met Master of Splits yet? We're doing Japanese food. Dual Starry, no! No! Chimera, don't encourage them. Cat Comp, you know what? Seriously? I would rather someone send me $10 in cash than a big expensive appliance because that $10 can go towards food. All good, Dual Starry. I know you're incredibly busy. Don't rush yourself, it's all good. Right now, I want to take a week off streaming so I can work out things to polish the stream. We want to figure out a few things, update stuff, which I just don't have the time. Because I spoke to Cripple Horse, he's having another meeting with his case manager in regards to me doing that job for him, the cooking job. I got one! No! No, Chimera, I've already got a coffee machine. It's hiding behind the penis, all right? Onichan, how are you doing? 1 second, John, I'll put the tits on once I do this. I just gotta pinch the bastard up. Let me go get the boobs. Serious, I have everything. I have a coffee machine. I don't have a bread maker anymore. I gave it to Cripple Claws because I don't use it. I make all my bread by hand. Because, you know, I'm an artisan cunt. A smokeless smoker. I have a smoker. Oh, shit. Where did my pop filter go? Couldn't have gone far. 1 second. I lost my pop filter. What the hell? Hang on. I might have been in the garage. Ah, there it is. Sly dog. Oh no, I have a bathtub. I have a bathtub. Yeah, I have a coffee machine. It's hiding behind the penis. But seriously, I have a meat smoker. I love my meat smoker. Dark Ixius and a few other streamers donated it to me like 2.5 years ago. 2.5 years ago, they donated me the money to get a smoker. Pop filter's in my undies. Oh, I hope there's no, like, you know, dick cheese on it, Schultz. I know, they're hanging a bit low. It happens when you get old, J-Dogs. Happens when you get old. I am 40, so, you know, my boobs are gonna sag a bit. As you can see on this apron. Alright. Two more I've got to fill. You need to see the bathtub. Well, maybe later I'll get VCam out and give you a house tour, but not right now. It's just a bathtub. It's, you know, you fill it with water, you sit in it, you clean yourself. You know, you pull the plug out, the water drains. It's just a tub. Last one. Like so. All right, once we're done here, we're gonna prepare our katsus. Katsu. Got tons of pork for the katsu too. All right, dumplings are done. Well, the boys are done. Look, Chimera, we tried to sell Kip's burps in a jar for $50, way cheaper than Amaranth's farts, and we got no takers, all right? We offered $50 for Kip's burp in a jar. No one was interested. We stopped it. I'm sorry, but what is it? She's got ethically sourced farts. That's just, I'm sorry. It's just so wrong. I can see Rhoda off behind the camera just laughing right there. You know, Amaranth is selling her farts in a jar for $1,000 USD. And they're ethically sourced farts. J-Dogs, as an Australian, peanut butter and jelly is not really a thing here. We have peanut butter and honey. As in Saab's, you know, this is Aussie land. All right, I'm gonna save this filling to do some gluten-free ones. So I'll put this in here. If you ask an Australian, do you eat peanut butter and jelly? The answer's gonna be, hell no. Why would I eat that? It's just not an Aussie thing. All right, I've got some pork. I'm gonna wipe down the bench, but I've got some pork here for our katsu. I'm gonna go get the breadcrumbs and everything for it. Peanut butter and together? No, Vegemite and cheese. Vegemite and cheese all the way. Peanut butter and Vegemite together? Oh God. That's a really weird combo. Cover you up. Actually, Tim, jam is different to jelly. Jam has fruit lumps in it. Jelly is like all smooth and all that kind of stuff. Thank you, Duastari, because I love peanut butter and honey. Peanut butter and jam, or you know, jelly, whatever you want to call it. It's just too gross. Honey and peanut butter like works way, way, way better. Weed! Oh! Speaking of weed, okay, alright? I'm gonna probably try and do a secret baking stream, but I'll have to make the wheat butter off camera. So the plan is I want to make hash cookies on stream, but you're not going to see me doing the canna butter. The canna butter is going to be off stream because I am not getting in trouble for that. So the plan will be I'm just going to go, here's my butter, chuck it in the bowl and make my fucking hash cookies. Much easier. All right, so our dumplings are ready. I'm gonna put them in the fridge until we're ready to steam them and fry them like the goises that they are. And we're now gonna start our pork katsu. I've got some pre-prepared pork fillet. I've got some pork sizzle steak right there. I'm just gonna get the crumbs and all that shit. And yeah, we're gonna be good to go. All right, pop that in there. You little fuckers are gonna chill for a bit. Because what I have here is panko crumbs. Panko crumbs, gluten-free panko, all that kind of shit. And the bottles are about to fall off and go everywhere. Yeah, Chimera, butter with oregano in it. It's gonna be butter with oregano in it. That's why it's gonna be green. Well, in this case, ghee. I'm gonna make canna ghee because I can't use butter. All right, there's a Twitch streamer who grows no, Onachan, it's illegal here in Australia. It has to be illegal in your country. Because it's illegal here, I am not allowed to do it on stream. That's the problem. Also, I've got all the food here, the rest of the ingredients and shit. So what we need is panko, MSG, white pepper. I need a couple of eggs and some gluten-free flour for this. Dulstar, I have been waiting for the day they legalize weed, but it's never gonna happen. It's never gonna happen. All right, regular panko, like so. Got my GF stuff. I know, they look so different. Gluten-free, non-gluten-free. I know it's not gonna be like the real thing, but it's still gonna be edible, so yeah. Yeah, liquid THC is illegal here, Tim. You're only allowed liquid CBD. CBD is the only one that's legal. All right, got that right there. Just remember, boys and girls, never have any edibles off Holidiver TV. You will be fucked for like a whole day. All right, so we're gonna add King of Flavor to both. Hey, Luck, how you doing? Welcome in. Tim, I wouldn't mind a THC lollipop. But again, we're gonna make cookies. White pepper. Like that. We're gonna make our egg wash, which is just basically egg and water. Crappy but alive, tell me about it. The pain I've got right now is horrible. All I'm doing is just like, you know, napping, resting up my body, taking pills. So two eggs. J-Dogs, thank you for the 100 bacon videos.
I made the mistake of eating 3/4 of an edible cookie one. I got super paranoid. It was my first and last time trying an edible. Lol.
The trick is, mate, start slow. Eat a quarter of it. Then see if you feel anything, and then half an hour later, have a little bit more. All right, so we've got our egg wash. What, we want a decent amount of white pepper in it. It's about a teaspoon. About a teaspoon. The thing is, John, smoking weed compared to ingesting it, you get a different high. You get a way different high when you smoke it. All right, so stir these together. Stir it together like that. I'm gonna get some flour out. Flour, flour, flour. Sorry?
I might go get more coke.
Oh, okay. I should have bought cans. I'm an idiot. I am such an idiot. I should have bought cans. I'm pretty lucky. Nothing like that's happened to me yet, you know? A little bit worried for a second, you know, because normally I'm the cunt who always gets my fucking credit card stolen. So we're gonna trim off any of the excess. Like these are really tiny pieces, because this was only like, I think, $8 or something. So, and we've also got bigger pieces right there. Oh, veal parmesan, yum, yum, yum. Oh, make veal cordon bleu. I love veal cordon bleu. Tortured baby cow makes the best cordon bleu, the best. Now we will be deep frying our katsu. We will not be, you know, oven baking it. You don't get the good crunch on it. Your pro VPN get hacked. Omnitron, in Australia, the government, they spy on your shit. The VPN's the only way to protect yourself from those dirty soy boys of the Australian government, who basically spy on you and report you to ISP companies for illegally downloading and all that stuff. Yeah, fuck that. I'm taking my chances with the VPN. One there. This is pork schnitzel / sizzle steak. This is basically pork, it's a chop, but it's the loin part that's been cut really thin. Really good for katsu. Really, really good for katsu. Just trim off the excess fat off it and the sinew, and you're pretty much, you know, you're good to go. It's good shit. And it's cheap. It's only like $8.90 or something. Beef is so expensive now. It's insane how expensive beef is. Remember, kids, VPNs don't prevent you from getting hacked. That is 100% true. No. VPNs will not prevent you from getting hacked. They will add a layer of protection against, you know, spying government entities. And I've got two more pieces here. What's a TV show person interest if you don't think the government has tech like that? They're listening to the call. You and I. Yeah, I know. The government spy on everything. On everything. You know, the Australian government has the right to take over your Facebook account for no reason. For no reason, they could just get the right to come into, basically gain access to your Facebook account and do whatever the fuck they want. You know the problem is with two-factor? It's not foolproof, Schultz. I've got two-factor authentication on a lot of my stuff and I still get my details and things hacked and all that. My PayPal's got two-factor authentication and it still gets hacked. It's fucking insane. It's absolutely nuts. Bitwarden. Kip uses Bitwarden. I've got Bitwarden on my phone. I just need to set the damn thing up. All right, so our pork pieces here are done. We're now going to start with crumbing them. I'm just going to get rid of this. Thing is, I've set up a Bitwarden account. I just haven't used it yet. I know, I'm a slack cunt. You know, that's just me. Poland has AGI. The lack of AGI makes the premises impossible. It was already shown that the NSA had issues actually going through all the data they suck up. My government told me the sky was blue. I will go outside and make sure. I don't trust a word with the Aussie government either. All right, so we've got fillet and sizzle steak, because that's not enough to feed four people, and leftovers for tomorrow. So we're going to dredge our pork in our seasoned flour, like so. Person of interest, is that show, does it have an Australian actor in it? I can't remember, there was some show that had an Australian actor in it that I fucking hate. And I can't remember if it's person of interest or not. Sorry, Lark. I don't know why, I don't know how this started. It started with downloading shit. Sorry, Lark. Bottom line is, governments are full of shit. They suck, they're assholes. You know, don't trust them, yada, 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 etc., etc. Have a good night, darling. Mwah. All right. Coat the piggy. It has the guy that played from Lost. I never watched Lost. I was one of those people that did not watch Lost. Never watched it. The idea of that show never interested me in the slightest. Alright, so we're just gonna coat our piggy with our season flower. Lost was, from what I hear, it was terrible. Everyone said apparently it just got really weird. Kip used to watch Lost, and it got really, really weird. And I'm kind of glad I never wasted my time watching that show. Yeah, that's what I heard, Semaphore. People started watching it, and they told me, don't even waste your time, because it's really, really bad. Markman, thank you for the resub for 21 months, you absolute legend. How you doing? Yeah, that's what everyone was telling me. It was a dumb show. That's why I never watched the damn thing. Never watched it. Didn't interest me. All right, let's start doing our piggy. I'll do gluten-free first, and I'm gonna do regular. Ow! Oh, got me right on the foot. I'm all right. Now, what it is, the joints in my fingers and hands are acting up at the moment. Oh man, that kills. That absolutely kills that. Well, so we have no idea where we're going, so we're gonna hint at everything. I never watched Blue Healers either, Schultz. I never did. My parents, I think, used to watch it. I was like, another cop show, you know? All right, so let's dunk our schnitty in there and give it a good crumbing, like so. Water Rats. Was that Channel 9? I know these aren't traditional panko because they're gluten-free, but they're the closest thing I can have to having katsu. So, it goes there. Save that one, save that one. And that one. Also get this one here. Oh, I used to watch Around the Twist on Channel 2. Who didn't as a kid? Hands up if you didn't watch it. The amount of times in class in primary school, you know, if the teacher wanted a break, they'll just put on Around the Twist. No, I've got to watch Silicon Valley, Tina. I watched Halt and Catch Fire. That show was brilliant. Oh my God, that show was amazing. It's a shame they canned it after, I think it was 3 seasons. Halt and Catch Fire, me and Kip binged watched it in like a week. Oh, the dust on this really goes up your nose and your throat. All right, that'll be enough gluten-free katsu. Now we're going to do the regular one. Let's put this over here. So we don't need that. Oh, sorry, I've already got the titty apron on. I can't change it right now. I'll get Kip to put ScumO on when he comes back. When Kip gets back, I'll get him to put ScumO on. But right now, yeah. Oh, Mr. Robot, I started watching that. That was a good show. That was really, really interesting. For some reason, I don't know why I stopped watching it. I think maybe something else came along that piqued my interest or something. Titsy. All right, so coat your pork really well. These are the regular katsu. The regular panko. Regular panko crumbs for crispy katsu. And we're gonna deep fry these fuckers because, you know, you don't want to oven bake them. You talking the original cartoon or that horrible movie with Matthew Broderick in it? Alright, so that one's done. Let's continue on. Sounds like a porn show. You know, there was the joke was go go gadget dick. And yeah, there was a joke about it, I think. I don't know if there was a porno about it. I'm not too sure. But you know, I wouldn't be surprised. There's a porno out there of everything. Right there. Put that in there. How am I doing? I'm actually doing pretty good for time. In an hour, I would have prepped the katsu. And the next time will be the sauces. What, Schultz? Oh my god! Is it about fucking Will Smith again? Is it about Will Smith again, Schultz? That in there, dunk that in there. You know the thing I have beef with panko? It's really hard for it to stick. You've got to really smoosh it on the bastards to actually get it to stick. And I'll give it an extra dunk. Did he really die? Really? Is Schultz bullshitting, or did Gilbert Gottfried actually die? Oh, he did die. Oh, shit. I only really remember him from Family Guy. He done a lot of like cameo voice things of Family Guy, Gilbert Gottfried did. Radio Melbourne, how are you doing? Welcome in. Thank you for bringing in your lovely rating party. Stick around, you mad cunts. We'll be back after this short message, I promise.
Warning, the following stream is classified SC for sick cunts and is not for viewing by easily offended pussies.
I don't know.
I was using it as a cum rag.
Cunts. Wrap your laughing gear around that. Radio Melbourne, how you doing? What? Just chatting. What was there a certain topic on today's stream, or was just basically chill, sit back, relax, chat, all that kind of shit? Thank you so much. Welcome in, everyone. Make it a Japanese feast for some guests from Victoria today. We've actually got some interstate guests who are going to be having a full-blown Japanese feast. Miso pork katsu, pork boiza, and vegetable kekiage nigiri sushi. Cookers them at... So the topic was cookers. Oh, man, that topic never gets old. Oof, that's the same thing. Ah, cookers. They give you a bit of, comedy relief in your otherwise dull day because of how stupid they are. Gazza, Dazza, Bazza, how you fucking doing, mate? Welcome in. Are they doing Lego Masters again, Tim Tammer? I thought Channel 9 scrapped Lego Masters. I can't watch that show, it'll make me want to buy a Lego, you know? So I'm just doing the pork katsu at the moment. And we've got one more, we've got a crumb. Just really get on there with the crumbs. Put it on there. Last piece of pork. Cookers, gotta love them. Gotta love them when they leave that preachy-ass letters in your mailbox, you know? Far out. I felt dirty after just touching the... They sent us this... we've received two lots of letters. This 8-page rant about the dangers of the vaccine and shit in our mailbox. They did it to everyone on the street. And prior to that, we got these handwritten notes. The other one that we got was, printed up. But the handwritten ones, oh my god, they just spew so much crap. Really, Tim? Dreamworld? Again, I just want to go there and buy Lego. 8 pages, Tina. It was an 8-page rant. What is it? Mobile 100 was jealous he didn't get one in his mailbox. All right, so we've done our pork. I'm just going to clean this up a bit. So we're gonna start making our sauces. We're gonna make our miso sauce for our katsu and our tonkatsu sauce for our kekiyaki nigiri. Boxes of Lego and wardrobe. Sounds like fun until I realize I can't be fucked putting together. I'm not 14 anymore. That's my idea of heaven, putting together Lego. You know? Are you for real, Gazza, in nappy boxes? What's wrong with the good old-fashioned letter drop in your mailbox these days? you know, is the letterbox doesn't do it for them anymore. But to be honest, I've seen them put them on the windscreens of cars, letterboxes. I've never heard about them putting them in nappy boxes before. You know, that's some pretty fucked up shit. No, miso sauce, M-I-S-O. Miso is, it's fermented soybean paste from Japan. It's so fucking good. So good. Anti-fax now sounds like a group I can get behind. Ban fax machines, embrace email, fax is a lie. Use modern tools. All right, let's get this in the thing. Yeah, we're gonna make the miso sauce and the tonkatsu sauce is going to be next. A fax is really big in Germany, Semaphore. You tell me you're still using like outdated fucking technology. You know, I have this wonderful thing called email. You have a fax online account so you can send faxes. I didn't even know that. Is that because of Gaza? Is that because of the 5G internet that causes, you know, problems and shit? Is that why that cunt's still using a 56k dial-up modem? Alright. Put these bastards in the fridge. Put that there. Here you go. Oh, middle of nowhere. Probably explains why it was... But you know what? There's this lovely thing called satellite internet. Places in the middle of nowhere here in Australia have they've been upgraded to satellite. All right, let me just clean this up because then I'm going to start making the sauces. And yes, that is a big blue penis for anyone who's wondering. That is a penis. Your eyes are not deceiving you. That's our kitchen mascot, ScoMo, the big penis. You know, named after the biggest walking cock in Australia, Scott Morrison. So yeah, your eyes are not deceiving you. Everyone always asks about the penis. They go, holy shit, is that a penis? Yeah, it is. Oh, I can understand now why he's only on 56k dial-up. Paranoia! Does Japan use a lot? Do you still use the fax as well? Huh. Starlink, that's Musk's one, isn't it? Elon's internet, eh? Man, I would love to be able to afford Starlink for IRL streams, but I'm so sick of my crappy internet cutting out because of fucking Telstra. Telstra suck. All right, let's make some sauces. Yum, 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 yum. Come with that shit is so crowded they start smashing into each other. Oh, the satellites. All right, for our sauces, for our tonkatsu sauce, we need tomato sauce, oyster-free oyster, Worcestershire, bit of tamari, MSG, sugar. Sugar, sugar, sugar. Thank you for the follow, Joshua Larry Mertz. How are you doing? Welcome in. All right, we're going to need a jug for this. I've got to pull up my recipe because I don't remember this at the top of my head. I have fiber here. I've got fiber to the fucking premises. I am not moving. Most places around here have fiber to the node. Few selected suburbs in my area have fiber to the premises, and this house has it. And I am not giving that shit up. All right, let me just bring up my recipe. Is that USD or AUD? I thought Starlink was like 250 AUD, like a month and shit. I thought it was like, because, you know, it's in USD, which is obviously a lot higher. My parents have satellite. They have to. There's no other internet available except the satellite where they are. It's going to be fun streaming from their house on Wednesday next week because their internet there is shit. All right, we need... I'm going to make about four times this amount. So I'm going to time it by four. Port, how you doing? Ukapaya, welcome in. Yeah, my parents live semi-rural.